friends, welcome back to my channel. So today I wanted to sit down and talk about a whole bunch of products that YouTube made me buy. Products that weren't really on my radar until I watched one of my favorite YouTubers talk about it, and then all of a sudden I was like, wow, I need that in my life, and then I went and I purchased it. Before I get started, I want to say I'm sorry if my voice sounds a little bit funky in this video. I've been feeling kind of under the weather this past week, and I did get my first dose of the COVID-19 vaccine on Wednesday, so I'm just like not really feeling 100%, and my voice is kind of reflecting that, but I really, really wanted to sit down and film this video for you, and also I am extra excited about it because it is in collaboration with my friend Kelly. Her Instagram and YouTube handle is KBellaBeauty, and she's awesome, and I just really, really want to tell you guys about her. So I discovered Kelly probably about 2 months ago or so, and literally since then she has become one of my like really good friends. I feel like I talk to her almost on a daily basis on Instagram, and I watch all of her YouTube videos. She is a teacher like myself, so I instantly connected with her because of that. And then also you can just tell when you're watching her videos that she just loves makeup and skincare so much. She is very knowledgeable. She is very thorough with her reviews. She will tell you if she likes a product and why. She's very thorough. She gives a whole bunch of details, and I just really, really love that. And a couple things that I love that she does on her Instagram account is on Saturdays, she will do a Saturday standout product. So she will come on every week and tell a product that she has just really, really been loving recently. And I think that's so fun because it's kind of like a rolling favorites video, like an updated in real time every week update favorites video of a product that she has just been loving recently. And then on Sunday, she does creator Sunday shoutouts, where she shouts out a creator that she's newly recently discovered and really has been loving recently. And I just think that's so cool. You can tell she's just a very sweet, sweet person. She seems to have a really good head on her shoulders. She seems to just be very genuine and lovely. And I am so glad that I finally discovered her. And she's been on YouTube for 5 years. This is 10, Emily. She's been on YouTube for 5 years, which I think is awesome. So she has been here a long time. She knows what she's doing. She did take a year off for her daughter, who is absolutely adorable, by the way. She will post about her in her Instagram stories every once in a while. And she's like the cutest thing ever. She has like the cutest curly hair. I think she's adorable. But yeah, Kelly is just, she's a really awesome person, and I am just really glad that her and I have become friends over Instagram and YouTube and all of that. And I wanted to tell you guys about her because she deserves all the love. So her and I are collaborating on this video. I'm going to talk about a whole bunch of products that YouTube made me buy, and she is going to talk about a bunch of products that YouTube made her buy. So I will have her video link, her Instagram, and her YouTube link all down below for you to go check it out. Please go ahead and check her out because she's seriously awesome, and I really do not think you would regret it at all. I've only done a couple collab videos in the past, and I'm always terrible and I always forget to do this, but if you are coming over from Kelly's channel, hello, thank you so much for clicking on my video, taking the time to hang out with me today. I really appreciate you watching. I hope you like what you see, and if you do, I invite you to click that subscribe button and hang out with me for a little while. I'm a little biased, but I feel like we have a lot of fun over here on this channel. We talk about new products, old products, we do a whole bunch of get ready with me's, faves and no ways, and just a whole bunch a fun makeup and skincare 11 video. So if that sounds interesting to you, go ahead and subscribe. Also, before we get started, don't forget I upload every Tuesday, Thursday, and Sunday for you guys. If you like this video while you're watching it, please go ahead and give it a big thumbs up. It really does help me out. And other than that, if you are excited and you want to hear a whole bunch of products that YouTube and YouTubers made me buy, then let's go ahead and get started. So with these products, I could have a ton more to talk about, I'm not gonna lie, like there's a lot of things that YouTube has made me buy, but I wanted to pick products that I didn't really have on my radar. I either really wasn't interested in them, or I didn't even know they existed until I saw on YouTube someone using it, someone talking about it, and then I was like, oh, okay, yeah, I really should buy that. The first product I wanna talk about, I actually do not have in my collection anymore, but I will pop a picture up here, and it is the Tatcha Silk Canvas Primer. It's the original version, not the liquid version that has came out since then, but I tried this a couple years ago, and you guys, when I thought of a product that YouTube made me buy, this was the first thing that popped in my head. And I'm gonna try to let you know what YouTuber persuaded me to purchase all of these different products, but this one was like every YouTuber under the sun, because literally, everyone was obsessed with this primer a couple years back, which is when I bought it and tried it. I haven't had it for probably like 2 years or so because I just tried it in the past. I don't know. I wasn't like a huge fan of this primer. I used the entire thing up because it's expensive. It's Tatcha and it was very expensive. I did get it during a Sephora sale, so I got, I think, 15% off then. That was back in the day before I was Rouge and I didn't spend as much money on makeup as I do now. But I don't know, this was just okay to me. Everyone just hyped it up and said it was like the best primer ever, and it didn't do much. It kind of pore filled for me, but it wasn't hydrating. I don't think it really helped my makeup wear really, really nicely throughout the day. I mean, it wasn't like terrible. Again, I used up the whole thing, so it wasn't like I hated it, but it was just very, very hyped, and a ton of YouTubers made me want to purchase it, and when I did, I don't know, I was just kind of disappointed in it. Next product I want to talk about is the ColourPop and Star Wars. This is their child palette from The Mandalorian. I just call him Baby Yoda, but he's so stinking cute. A ton of YouTubers made me want to buy this, specifically Samantha March and then Kelly. She did a review video on this palette and I watched it and I just thought it was a really great review. And then Samantha March had this as her, I want to say like top ColourPop palette from 2020. I watched that video she did. I can't remember if it was her top one or her second top one, like her favorite palette from ColourPop in 2020. Am I explaining that correctly? I think I am. But this is a beautiful palette. It's a palette that I actually have on my eyes today. I went ahead and used Just Like a Tattoo one in my crease, and then I used Float Your Crib on the outer corner and up into the crease, and then I put this The Force like beautiful gold shade on my lid, and then Precious Cargo as my inner corner highlight. So yeah, this was one that I had this on my radar and I thought it was really, really cute, and I love green eyeshadow, but I wasn't sure if I was gonna buy it. I was on the fence, I didn't need it. And then I just saw a bunch of reviews on it on YouTube and I was like, yes, yes, I need this palette. So I bought it. The next product is a BB cream that I really do not think I am the only person to purchase this because Jessica Braun, and it is the Misha Perfect Cover BB cream. She just raves about this BB cream and has been raving about it for years. She said she's gone through like, I don't know, like 4 or 5 tubes of it at this time, which is like a lot, especially since she is a very large YouTuber and tries a whole bunch of makeup all the time. I like this, I do. It's not my favorite complexion product ever, but I do really enjoy it. You can tell I have used quite a bit up of it. I have the shade number 13. It is bright beige. She has said recently that they are, I think, reformulating it and also expanding the shade range, which thank goodness, because their shade range is pretty abysmal, I'm not going to lie, which she admits to that when she talks about this product too. But I will say it is very beautiful on the skin. It's a nice medium coverage product. It has more coverage for a BB cream than I was really expecting it to, not gonna lie. But it covers up enough. I just have to go on with like a concealer where I need a little bit more coverage. But it wears beautifully on the skin. It does have a scent to it. It's like a, I don't know, fresh, clean scent. So if you are sensitive to scents, I don't think you would like this. But it is really beautiful on the skin and I'm glad I picked it up. And it's also like, I feel like $10 or $12 on Amazon, so it's a pretty affordable product as well. And yeah, Jessica Braun, she definitely made me buy this, and this is not the only item on my list that she has made me buy, so. The next one is the Persona Liquid Lipstick. This is in the shade Holy Grail. Samantha March 1,000,000% made me buy this. She was wearing this in one of her videos a couple months back, and I literally just kept like, oddly, kept like staring at her lips her whole video, because I was like, that is the most beautiful red shade I have ever seen in my entire life. It is absolutely stunning on her. It made her teeth look so white, and just, she looked beautiful. I mean, she always looks beautiful, but she extra looked beautiful in this video with this red lipstick. And I was like, what is that? What the heck is that? And I scrolled down in the description box and saw that it was the Persona Liquid Lipstick again in Holy Grail, and I immediately bought it. Because it just looks so stunning on her, and I was like, I need that red liquid lipstick in my life, so I bought it. And I'm not gonna lie, I've only used it once, but it is stunning, and this formula is so stinking comfortable. It's thin but super pigmented, so I dipped in one time, the one time I used it. I ended up using it in my holiday glam get ready with me. I can link up in the eye for you so you can see it in action on my lips, and it is just beautiful. It's a really thin formula, but it's very opaque, so you just need to go in like really with one swipe, and it wears so nice. It is not drying on the lips at all. It wore all day long, and I am so glad that Samantha March persuaded me to buy this because it is stunning. Okay, the next product, I'm not gonna lie, I kind of regret buying a little bit, but I should have probably thought it through more before I bought it. And it is the Wet n Wild bronzer in the shade Reserve Your Cabana. Kelly Strack just hardcore made me want to buy this. She uses, this is a bronzer, which is so odd to me that this is considered a bronzer considering how light it is. Like, that doesn't make, like, who is this a bronzer for, Wet n Wild? Who? Not even me. Like, I am fair as fair can be, and I could not use this as a bronzer. But how Kelly Strack uses this is she uses it to set under her eyes, and she just made it look so stunning and talked it up so, so much in all of her videos. And I would watch her use it, and I watch how like flawless it made her under eyes look, and I was like, I want that in my life. And she kept talking about how she thought it was discontinued, it was really, really hard to find. So I found it at my local, I think, Dollar Tree or Dollar General, I think it was Dollar General, a while ago. And so I was like, oh my gosh, like this is the setting powder that Kelly Stark uses. I want to try it out. And I bought it, and it's just like a little dark for me, because if you have ever seen Kelly Stark's videos, she self tans and she is a whole lot tanner than I am. And she can use this as a setting powder under her eyes and I cannot. And I don't know why I didn't think that through. That was just kind of like a error of judgment on my part, because I can't use this to set under my eyes, but I also can't use it as a bronzer. So I will use it a couple times. Maybe in the summer, if I start using my Isle of Paradise tanning drops again, I will be able to use this to set my face like she does. But yeah, it's a good thing it's Wet n Wild, so it was only a couple dollars, so I wasn't out like a ton of money. I definitely just should have thought it through. But yeah, Kelly Stark made me buy this. One I've talked about quite a bit recently, so I won't harp on it too long, but it is the e.l.f. Primer Infused Blush in the shade Always Hazy. Taylor Wynn made me buy this. She just 1,000,000% made me buy this. She talked about it in one of her most recent favorites videos. I think it was like her favorite products of 2020 video, and she talked about this, and I was like, yeah, yep, need that in my life. So I went and bought it. It is the blush that I have on my cheeks today. It's a blush that I've had on my cheeks in tons of other videos too, because I cannot put it down. I can't put it down. It is absolutely stunning. Actually, one of my friends, Courtney, just bought this kind of based off my recommendation, based off Taylor Wynn's recommendation, and I'm really hoping she loves it when she tries it out. I'm like, let me know. You know how when you like recommend something to someone and they try it and you're just like stalking them, like, what do you think? Did you like it? Did you hate it? What's going on? So I feel like I'm gonna be texting her like every day this week, like, did you try the blush yet? What do you think? Do you like it? But yeah, Taylor Wynn made me buy this, and I am so, so glad that I did, because it's my new obsession. It's like one of the most beautiful blushes I've ever put on my cheeks, and it's e.l.f. So it's super, super affordable. Okay, I don't really watch Brianna Fox too often, but I kind of recently discovered her in the last month or so, and I've been like slowly catching up on her videos, trying to see if I vibe with her. I mean, do you guys do that too when you like find a new YouTuber? You have to like watch quite a few of their videos, I think, before you realize, yes, I want to subscribe to them. So I'm like trying to feel her out, but I think I like her. I think what I've seen of her videos, I really, really do enjoy. And I don't remember what video she mentioned this in, but she talked about it and I immediately went and bought it. It is the IGK 30,000 Feet Volume Powder Spray. So she was talking about how she uses this in her roots. She just sprays it in there and kind of fluffs it up, and it just gives her hair extra volume. And I have no volume in my hair. It is very thick and heavy, and I think that's why like my roots are very flat a lot of the time. I just don't have a lot of volume in my hair, which stinks. So when she was talking about this and how easy it is to use, she really, really made me want to go buy it, and I'm pumped, because when I did buy it, it was half off at Sephora. It was like on sale. I like this. I used it in my hair today, if you can see. I don't know. I don't know if I'm not using enough or I'm not using it correctly, but she like demonstrated her using it in the video, and I feel like I use it the same way she does, and it just doesn't give my hair a whole lot of volume. Maybe that's the point. Maybe it's not supposed to, and it's just supposed to give you like a little bit of oomph. And it does that, I think. But yeah, I don't know. Also, it's kind of hard to like get out. It's like a powder that you press this down. So I like lift my hair up and I like try to go like that. And I feel like not a lot of powder comes out at once. So maybe that's why, that's kind of why I think maybe I'm not using enough of it. I don't know. I like this. I'm gonna use it up, and it's not like terrible. And I like that it doesn't make my hair look dry or oily or really anything. It's pretty undetectable in your hair, minus like giving you a little bit of volume. So I do like this. I'm glad I bought it. And Brianna Fox made me wanna buy it, man. She talked it up. She made me want to buy it. Okay, the next product is from a YouTuber that was very large, and she used to be one of my favorites, and she kind of fell off. I don't really know what's going on with her. Tati, you remember Tati? Tati Westbrook? Does that ring a bell? Because she used to be huge and then got in some drama, and now she doesn't make videos anymore. I don't know. I miss her. Honestly, I do. I miss her videos a lot. I hope that one day she comes back. I don't know if she's going to, guys. I really don't. She just has taken a lot of time off, and I don't know what's going on with that. But the product that she really, really made me want to buy is the Tarte Timeless Smoothing Primer Base. This is a pore filling primer, and as you can tell, I've used a ton of it. Like, I love this primer so, so much, and she just raved about it on her videos all of the time in the past, talking about how it's like the best pore filling primer she's ever used, and it works super, super well. And I agree. I think it's great. It's not one that you can use all over your face, and you don't really want to use a lot. So if you buy this, or if you own it and you like used it and you're like, what the heck, I don't see the hype. Less is more with this product. I just use a little bit on like my middle finger, and I will rub it together, and then I mash it into my T-zone. like mash it into my pores. I want it inside of my pores to just like completely smooth them over and completely fill them in and give me like a very smooth base. And that's what it does. I just kind of like mash it into my pores, on my nose, in my chin, like on my chin area, and then in my forehead, so like my T-zone. And that's really the only place you really need to use it. Like I said, it's not one you can use all over your face, but this does, I feel like it really does smooth out my face, smooth out my pores. I am not someone who really struggles with my pores showing a lot with foundations. I mean, every once in a while, I'll just try a terrible foundation formula that just really doesn't work out for me. In that case, it does emphasize my pores, but usually I don't, but I still use this anyways, even though that's not a struggle I really have. But yeah, like I said, I just get a little bit, mash it into my T-zone, and it really is super, super pore filling. And she just talked about it so many times that I was like, yeah, yep, I need to buy it. And so I did. Going back to my girl, Jessica Braun, she is one of my favorites, guys. I really do love her and her videos. She made me buy this Eco Tools Duo Fiber Stipple Brush. This is like one of her favorite brushes ever. She uses it all of the time in Get Ready With Me for her bronzer. I bought it because she just talked it up and she said she loved it so much. I would see her using it and applying her bronzer in videos, and it really did look so lovely. She would just put in her bronzer and just go like this a couple times, and it would just diffuse it and spread it out and blend it in so, so nicely. And when I got it, I don't know if it's because it's a newer brush, so it's still kind of densely packed. Maybe hers is a little more used and worn, obviously, because she loves it so much. But the couple times I used it, it made my bronzer get kind of patchy. So I haven't used it too much since like the first two times I tried it, because when you try something and it doesn't work out for you, and then you're like, oh, I don't want to try that again. You know what I mean? That's kind of what I am having with this brush right now, because I'm just like, I don't want patchy bronzer. So I'm going to try it again, but she definitely was the one that made me want to buy this. And the last two products I have to talk about is a duo that I'm absolutely head over heels in love with, and I was persuaded to buy them from two of my favorite YouTubers ever, and it is the Shiseido Synchro Skin Self-Refreshing Oil-Free Foundation and the Shiseido Synchro Skin Self-Refreshing Oil-Free Concealer. This was persuaded by Samantha March, and this was persuaded by my girl, Jessica Braun. I love both of them, and neither one of them steered me wrong in this duo with these products, because they are just amazing. Oh my gosh, you've heard me talk about this a million times, so I'm not gonna harp on it too much, but this is like my favorite foundation recently. It is so stinking good. It's not insanely full coverage, but it covers everything I need it to cover, and it just looks beautiful on the skin and wears so, so nicely. And this is a pretty good match for me. I have the shade 130 Opal. And yeah, Samantha March just talked about how much she loved it, and I got it on sale during the Sephora sale a couple of months back. It's kind of pricey. It's $47 for a foundation, which is a lot of money, I'm not gonna lie. But like I said, I got it on sale. I do recommend getting it on sale. But yeah, this is just, it's so stunning on the skin. Every time I wear it, I love how my makeup turns out. I love how it wears all day, and it's just beautiful. And then same thing for the concealer. I ended up buying the concealer because I love the foundation so, so much. And like I said, Jessica Braun loves it too. And this is a really great concealer. It's the concealer I have on my eyes today, and it just covers so, so well. And this probably creases the least on me out of all of the concealers that I own, which is so nice, because I really do struggle with concealers creasing on me really badly. I mean, I have under eye lines, so makeup gets in them and crease, you know what I mean? And Jessica Braun said this is one of her favorite concealers because it doesn't crease. And I definitely, definitely agree with that. I mean, it still creases on me, but just less than other concealers, if that makes sense. But yeah, I love this combo so, so much. And I love Samantha March and Jessica Braun so, so much. And that was it, you guys. That was a bunch of products that my favorite YouTubers made me purchase. They just talked about them, hyped them up so much that I was like, I need that in my life. And I went and purchased them. I had so much fun doing this video, thinking of products that like really, like what products did I buy because of YouTube? And it was so, so much fun. Most of these I really do love and genuinely enjoy, and I'm very happy that I bought it based off YouTube recommending them to me. Thank you again so much to Kelly for collaborating with me on this video. Again, go check out Kelly's video, channel, Instagram, all of the above. She is really, really awesome. I really, really do not think that you would regret checking her out. She is so, so great. Other than that, if you made it to the end of this video, thank you so much. You're awesome and I love you. Please subscribe if you have not yet, and I hope to see you in my next video. Bye, guys.